Let me go on to one more topic.
Yeah.
And that's relates to PE. So PE is obviously
this PE thing, physical education.
Private equity. It's moved into the accounting world in a big way
in
the last few years.
Yeah.
And for reference, for those that want to see a pre-PE interview, you and I did one right before PE started.
Love that.
And you predicted
it. We did that on the other side of the living room with the fireplace behind us.
I think so.
But it's 70 degrees outside today, so.
Yeah. Well, the world has changed for accounting firms and the entry of PE and the discipline that it's bringing. What are the arguments? And there's, you know, there's people have different views on it. And you've been part of that discussion. But this is what I want to focus on. One of the arguments that is made in favor of the PE model, okay, is that it provides for more streamlined leadership, management, more sort of less consensus orientation, okay? So here's the first question. Can the partnership model, no PE, can the partnership model work as good as the PE model?
So the answer is no and yes. And Russ, this is your best question of the day. It's loaded. You know, I sometimes say things in the press and I get some nasty phone calls. So one article that lit up was this, the fatal flaws of the partnership model. And I got a call from a firm that prides itself as being a partnership, not being PE owned, and being uber successful. And I said to the individual, I said, I think you're mixing up words here. I said, you have a corporate model already. You've had that for 20 years. You make tough decisions, fast decisions, you know, really good decisions, and leaders lead. So when I talk about the fatal flaws of a partnership, I'm talking not so much about a partnership to a corporate model. I'm talking about the ability to make decisions, tough decisions, lots of them. How you do that, and in this particular firm, partners feel like partners, but the leaders lead and they make the tough calls. There are many firms that are partnership run and partners make all the decisions. Everything comes to the table. You know what the problem with that? Any one person can say no, but no one can say yes, not even the leader. It reminds me of in banks, loan departments, loan committee meetings to decide which borrowers we're going to take on. Any person in the room can say no to the loan, but how are we going to say yes? So it's not the flaw of being a partnership. It's the flaw of things coming to a point. Yes, PE has come in and elevated decision-making in a way that does make firms more accountable and ultimately more profitable. So if that's a little bit what you're asking.
So what you're saying, if I could try to just put it in my own words, is that the PE slash corporate model is much more conducive to decision making, but a partnership owned by practicing accountants, attorneys, whatever, can get to the same place with disciplined leadership.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, I won't use names, but in the top 20, there's three firms. They all begin with a C. I don't think in this lifetime they'll do a private equity deal. They don't need to do a private equity deal. Life is great, and they make tough decisions and they lead. And they've found ways to get capital within. There are other firms in the top 20 that begin with a C, and you'll see them probably in 2024, 2025 do a private equity deal. It doesn't mean that their leadership was flawed. It meant that they wanted a capital and strategic partner. You know, so much gets garbled sometimes in what goes on.
Thank you so much, Allan. This was fantastic.
Russ,
that runs on my questions. I don't know if you had anything else you wanted to mention.